Hello guys, this is Basuraj Chukkimut. Now we are going to learn about first module DC circuit in basic electrical engineering according to the syllabus of Vishveshwaraya Technological University, Belagavi, Karnataka. Let us begin this module. So the outline of this chapter is Ohm's law, Kirchhoff's law, analysis of resistance in series, parallel and combinations of both power and energy. So looking at this, we'll come to know almost all this we have learned in our PUC level. So therefore I will take the brief idea about all these concepts. Let us begin with that. What is circuit? Actually, the electrical elements connected in closed path so that electrical current flows through it is called circuit. So here the electrical elements means actually resistor, inductor and capacitor. All these elements are connected in closed path so that electrical current flows through it is called circuit. Then what is DC circuit? Very simple. DC circuit nothing but the closed path followed by direct current. The closed path, this is a resistor, the closed path followed by direct current is called DC circuit. This is AC circuit because the closed path is followed by AC, and this is a DC circuit because the DC the circuit follows, the closed path follows direct current. Okay, let us begin with the Ohm's law. So according to the Ohm's law, we know that the applied voltage V is directly proportional to I, where V is equal to I into R. In this case, R is nothing but proportionality constant, that is what you can call this as resistor. Fine. Let us represent these things as a circuit. This is R. Applied voltage V. Okay, fine. This V and the closed path followed by current I. So this is one of the very simple law which explains about Ohm's law. Let us represent all these parameters in graph. Say along the y-axis V, along the x-axis I. The V and I directly proportional, therefore I will get at one straight line with 45 degree. So the slope of this one is what you can call as resistance. Resistance is property, resistor is material. Okay. So but Ohm's law has certain amount of limitations. This Ohm's law is not applicable for all temperature conditions, not applicable for semiconductor, and also not applicable for non-linear networks. Okay, let us begin with that KCL. So in the KCL, what is said that the algebraic sum of current at node or junction, current at node or junction is equal to zero. Let us understand this. So here is the one junction. This junction is connected with n number of branches. Randomly, I will take that. Okay, fine. Say this is I1, this is I2, this is I3, this is I4 and I5. Okay, so algebraic sum of current, that means to make this algebra, let me write all currents here, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5 equal to 0. To make it algebra, I need to assign for each current. To assign this one, I would like to give one simple keyword, that is LPG gas, liquid petroleum gas, let you know that. L means living current, P means positive. Whatever the currents are living in junction, let me consider it positive. So that just make very easy to understand about it. Fine. So I1, I2, I3, all our currents are moving towards this junction. So therefore, minus sign, minus sign. But I4 and I5, both are leaving the junction. So therefore, I will consider this as a positive. Then, sir, if I take I1, I2, I3 into the right hand side, then equations become I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to I4 plus I5. So its claim says that incoming current is equal to outgoing current. So the KCL can also explain as incoming current is equal to outgoing current. Let us move to KVL. The KVL state that algebraic sum of all voltages. Here the term all voltages means it speaks about voltage drop we can see across resistor, and voltage rise. It is found that voltage rise is found that sources. Okay, EMF. Yeah. Let us understand this one through the circuit. Let me begin with that. First, voltage rise from the EMF source, battery. So then one resistor, another resistor, one more extra resistor. Okay, so connect all in closed path. Yes, say this is V1, this is R1, this is R2, this is R3, and this is V2. The easiest way to apply KVL is, don't worry about that, the sign of the battery. Do one thing, that is, assume the current is always flows in clockwise direction. So like this, irrespective of any direction of the sources. Then say this is first current I1, this is I2, the current in the second loop. So let us apply KVL to the first loop. At first loop, we're going to apply at loop 1. Okay, let us check it out what happens with the KVL. So V1. So what I do usually to explain this, what I do that I will take branch wise. It is very easy to understand. Okay. So now moving from A to B in this one, the end sign of this battery is positive. So therefore you say this is plus V1. Then current is moving from B to C. The current is always moving from higher potential to the lower potential. So therefore higher potential is indicated by positive sign and lower potential is indicated by negative sign. Similarly, current is moving from C to D, therefore indicate this is a positive sign, this is negative sign. Let us apply the KVL there. So B and C. So in the between the branch B and C, the current is I1 flowing, so therefore voltage drop is I1 into R1 because end sign is minus sign. Similarly, minus I1 R3. But R3 is common between loop number 1 and 2, so therefore we have to consider current I2 also. The end sign is plus, so therefore plus I2 into R3 is equal to 0. Okay then, so let us rearrange this equation. So I1 into R1 plus R3 minus sign plus I2 into R3 equal to minus P. Say this is equation number 1. Similarly, at loop 2. Okay. Let us begin. Let us give a name. A, C, D, E, F. Okay. From C to E, the current is moving from C to E. So this is plus minus. Already this is plus minus. It's the default. Then this is plus minus. Let's apply here then. So the first, let's begin with the C to E. So what is the voltage drop here? That is R2 into I2. What the end sign is here? Minus V2. Here there is no voltage, any resistance, then voltage drop is 0. From D to C, what is the voltage drop here? That is minus R3 into I2. But already we know that R3 is common between loop number 1 and 2. So therefore I need to consider current I1 also. What is the end sign here? So the second loop is end sign is plus. So therefore plus I2 into R3. Sorry, not I2. This is I1 equal to 0. Okay, let us rearrange this. So after rearranging, this is I1 into R3 minus R2 plus R3 into I2 is equal to V2. So this is equation number 2. So you can solve this equation number 1 and 2 by using Cramer's rule or simultaneous method or by using calculator. So the easiest way to use is calculator, use it equation mode, then you can directly you'll get that I1, I2 for known values of R1 and R2 and P1 and V2. Fine. Let us move to that. Next, resistance in series. Okay, let's consider two resistors. Here this is R1 and R2. When both resistors are connected, the equivalent resistance between the terminal A and B is what we can call R equivalent is nothing but it is R1 plus R2. Let us connect one voltage source across the combinations of this. Okay, so this is V and current in the closed path is I. So where I is nothing but it is upper voltage V divided by R1 plus R2. Here the one observation what we can do, the current in R1, current flowing through R1 and R2 is same. Well, so now the voltage due to the flow of this current, voltage drop across R1 is, let us say, V1, the voltage drop across R2 is, say, V2. Well, so V1 can be calculated by using the formula V is equal to I into R1. What is I means here? I is nothing but it is V into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Similarly, V2 can be calculated V into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. From these two equations, what you get that when resistance are connected in series, it acts as a voltage divider circuit. And one more observation is current is same. When resistance are connected in series, current is same but voltage is different. Therefore, what we can call, when resistance are connected in series, it acts as a voltage divider circuit. Okay, let us go to that. When resistance are connected in parallel, so it is resistance are both are connected in parallel. Okay, let us redraw that. First resistance, second resistance R1, R2, okay. Both are connected in parallel to the terminal A and B. Okay, so what is the equivalent resistance? Already we know that when resistance are connected in parallel, directly under that is R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Let us connect that one voltage source across the parallel combinations of these two. Okay, fine. This is say V and this is say I. So at this junction, current is going to divide into two parts. This is I1, this is I2. Let us calculate current here. What is the total current? That is, total current I is equal to V divided by R equivalent. But here, when resistance are in parallel, this is R1, when resistance are in parallel, the voltage drop across this is same. That means, say this is V1 and V2 is the voltage drop across resistor. That means V is equal to V1 is equal to V2. Here, in this equation, what we can say, V is equal to I into R equivalent. Okay, let's calculate I1 then. After knowing this, I1 is equal to V1 divided by R. What is V1? V1 and V are the same. So therefore, let us say V is equal to I R equivalent. What mean by R equivalent is here? So R equivalent is nothing but R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. this R1, this R1 get cancelled. Finally, what is left for me? That is I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Similarly, I will go for I2. I2 is equal to main current. When I1 is here, I consider resistance in another branch. So therefore, now I am collecting I2. That means I have to consider another resistance, that is R1. R1 divided by R1 plus R2. So from seeing these two equations, what we can get the conclusion is, when resistance are connected in parallel, it is acts as a current divider circuit. Current divider circuit. And one more observation is, what you can say, voltage drop is same. Voltage drop across resistors are same. Drops are same. This is all about when resistance are in series and parallel. Okay, let us see power. Electrical power is nothing but the total work done in an electrical circuit is called electric power. Work done in electrical circuit is nothing but one voltage is required to raise one coulomb of charge. Okay, that is what we call work done. So here I will rewrite this one as like this, V into Q divided by T. So where V is as it is, Q by T, charge with respect to time is nothing but current. So the product of voltage and current is usually what we call electrical power. So by using the Ohm's law, this can be written that V square divided by R, or this also written that I square into R. The unit of electrical power is usually in terms of watts. Okay, let us move to electrical energy. The electrical energy is nothing but the product, the total work done in an electrical circuit is called electrical energy. That is nothing but, already we know that electrical power is represented by term P. The P into time is nothing but what you can say, electrical energy. If I consider unit of electrical energies, we will not measure in terms of the joules. Here we will say in terms of watt second. For larger time, we will say it is watt hour. For larger power and time, what you can call this as a kilowatt hour. So as you know that in our home, the electrical consumption is measured by in terms of units. That means one unit of energy consumption is exactly equal to 1 kilowatt hour. That means 1 kilowatt hour is nothing but one unit. Okay, let us move to the problems. These problems are from old question paper as well as model question paper. Let us check it out what we need to do in this problem. In this problem, we need to do the total power dissipated in each resistor for below shown circuit diagram. This carries 8 marks. Okay, so what we need to do? First, we will calculate current in the each branches. That is going to help us to calculate the the power dissipated by each resistor. Okay, let me, before doing that, I'll say this terminal as A and this terminal as B. So whatever the current is moving with the terminal A and B, that means current flowing through this 3 ohm and 6 ohm is same. So that means here what you can say, it is a 2 ampere. After this 2 ampere, the current is going to divide into two parts. The first part is, let me say I1, this is the current flowing through 5 ohm, and the next current is I2, that is the current flowing through 2 ohm. So according to the KCL, so what you can say, 2 ampere. 2 ampere is equal to I1 plus I2. Okay, if I say this as a total as I1, then so I is equal to I1 plus I2. Okay, fine. Let us calculate I1. So as you know that when resistors are connected in parallel, it acts as a current divider circuit. So therefore, so I1 can be calculated in such a way that main current is here 2 ampere. 2 ampere. and resistance in another branch, because I'm calculating current in 5 ohm, but I have to consider current in another resistance, resistance of another branch, that is 2 divided by total resistance, that is 2 plus 5. So that is equal to, so 2 into 2, 4, 2 plus 5, 7. So 4 plus 7 is, 4 divided by 7 is 0.5272 MPa. Okay. Similarly, we'll calculate I2. I2 is equal to main current. Main current is 2 Ampere. Resistance in another branch, because I'm calculating current here I2, that is current from the 2 ohm, but I have to consider resistance in another branch, that is 5 ohm divided by total resistance, that is 10 divided by 7, that is equal to 1.428. Well, so now we calculated I1 and I2. The next is we'll calculate the power dissipated by each resistor. Let us begin that first power dissipated from 3 ohm resistor. That is, the current is here 2 ampere, that is I square into R, 2 square into 3. So 4 into 3, 2 square into 4, 3, 12 watt. Then next power dissipated by 5 ohm resistor. So current I1 is here 0.5272 square into resistance is 5 ohm. So answer is 1.63 watts. Next, power dissipated by 2 ohm resistor. The current in the 2 ohm is I2. I2 is 1.428 square into 2 ohm. So answer is 4.078 watt. Then power 6 ohm, current flow through the 6 ohm is 2 square into 6. So 4 into 6, 24 watt. So the total power consumed by circuit is nothing but the power dissipated by each resistor, that is P3 ohm, P5 ohm plus P2 ohm plus P6 ohm. The sum of all this power is nothing but the total power dissipation, that is 41.714 watt. You can also calculate the total power like this, that is the total current. Total current is how much here? 2 square into sum of all these resistors, that means 3 plus 5 ohm, 2 ohm, both are in parallel combinations. So therefore 5 ohm is in parallel with the 2, and again the combination is in series with the 6 ohm. If I solve this, answer must be 41.714 watt. Okay, so this is all about first numerical. Let us move to the second numerical. So in this one, let us read the statement carefully, and based on that we'll put the diagram. Two resistors are connected in parallel. Okay, first I will draw two resistors in parallel. First resistance, second resistor. Sorry, most of the times I'm using resistor. What is the resistor? Is considered that as a resistor. Sorry for my words. Okay. Two resistors are connected in parallel, and voltage of 200 voltage is applied to the terminals. Okay, this is the terminal, and the voltage applied is 200 volts. Right. Okay, say this is R1 and this is R2. Okay, the total current taken is 25, total current, just like your I1, this is 25 ampere, and the power dissipated in one of the resistor is 1500 watts. Okay, let me consider whatever the power dissipated anyone. So I will say across R1 R1, it is 1500 watts. Okay, this is the power dissipated. What is the resistance of each element? Okay, so with this data, what you need to do, you have to calculate R1 and R2. So before, what I say, I will make some arrangement here. Say, what are the current flowing through R1 is I1, and current flowing through R2 is I2. Due to the flow of this current, we will get that voltage drop this as a V1, and the voltage drop this one as a V2. Already we know that when resistors are running parallel, so the voltage drop across the resistors are same, that is V1, V2 is equal to V, and it acts as a current divider circuit. Okay, let us say V1, V2, V is equal to 200. Can I calculate this resistance by using that Ohm's law formula, that is P is equal to V square divided by R1? So from this, what do you say? R1 is equal to V square divided by P. So V square is nothing but here 200 square, and P is nothing but 1500 watts. So after solving this, answer is 26.6670. Okay. Then to calculate I2, what is required is I have to calculate I2. If you want to calculate R2, I2 is required. So before to calculate I2, what I need to do, I have to find I. So therefore, as you know, I is equal to I is total current, that is 25, is equal to I1 plus I2, where I1 can be easily calculated, that is 200, it is the voltage drop because that divided by 26.667, that is equal to I1 is equal to 7.5 ampere. After round up, we will get that 7.5 ampere. Then from this equations, what we can say, I2 is equal to 17.5 ampere. So I1 is, if it is 7.5, then I2 is equal to 25 minus 7.5, let us get that 17.5 ampere. Once you know that I2, it is very easy to calculate R2, because R2 is equal to V divided by I2. What is that V? V is here 200. What is I here? That is 7.5. So therefore, the resistance R2 is 11.423 ohms, 4 to 3 or 4 to 4, after round up, look at that. So the final answer, what you can say, R1 is 26.667 ohms, then R2 is equal to 11.423 ohms. Go to the next point. For a given circuit, calculate the value of R, the current in either branch, and the value of the unknown resistance R, when the total current taken by the network is 2.5 ampere. Okay, so what is saying that the total current is, he is saying that 2.25 ampere. To make it more easy, I'll redraw this diagram like this. First, two resistance, that means 2 ohm and 8 ohm. Actually, this is 8 ohm. There is a printing mistake. 8, then 5 ohm, then R, unknown resistance. Okay, so this is connected across 10. This is 10 volt, and main current is 2.25 ampere. One thing, see here, 2 ohm and 8 ohm, these two are connected in series, and the combination of these two is in parallel with this. That means whatever the voltage drop across this is same. The combinations of this is 10 volt. Let me say V1 across this one and this is V2. So all this V1, V2 is equal to 10 volt. So when resistance are connected in series, it is acts as a voltage divider. Once I know that voltage here, so I can easily calculate how much current and all, isn't it? So therefore what we do, first we'll calculate the voltage drop across this one ohm as a V1 dash, and this is V1 double dash. Okay, so first we'll calculate V1 dash. V1 dash is nothing but the mean voltage. Mean voltage means 10 here. Okay, same resistance, that is 2 divided by total resistance, that is 2 plus 8. So 10 into 2, 20 divided by 2 in plus 8, 10, it is 2 volt. 2 volt. Okay, so then this is one way. Another way I'll explain you later, not a big deal. Okay, 2 volt. So after once we know 2, what is the current flow from this one? Can calculate very easily, because I is equal to, it is I1. Let me say this is I1. Okay, I1 is equal to V1 dash divided by 2. V1 dash is 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1 ampere. Then what is the voltage drop across this one? V1 double dash. V1 double dash is very simple. So that is 1 into 8. So it is 8 volt. So now we'll come to know that the current is here 1 ampere. And here what about I2? Very simple, because by using the KCL, the here the current is given two parts. So therefore what you can say, I2 is equal to 2.25 in current minus I1. I1 is 1 ampere, that is 1.25 ampere. So whatever the current flowing through the and the I2 is 1.25. So once you know that current, is it possible to calculate the voltage drop across this 5 ohm? So the voltage drop across 5 ohm is equal to 1.25 into 5. The answer is, that is 6.25 volt. Then what is the voltage drop across R ohm? That's very simple, because it's connected in series. So therefore 10 minus 6.25, that is equal to 3.75 volts. Once I know that voltage, already current is calculated, that is 1.25. therefore it is very easy to calculate R, that is R is equal to 3.75 volt divided by current, that is 1.25. Answer is 3 ohm. So unknown resistance is here, R is equal to 3 ohm. That is the final answer. Okay, let us move to the next problem and last problem. For the circuit shown in figure, obtain voltage between the point X and Y. In such cases, what you do, you can apply KVL directly, or so the which method you feel you can follow that. What I do, I will follow that. The easiest way, I'll consider current flowing according to the direction of the battery. Usually current is always move from positive this terminal. I'll assume that current is moving in this way. Let me call this as a I. And here the positive of the battery is this side. So therefore I'll assume that current is moving in this direction. So this is I2. First I'll calculate I1 and I2. That makes me to calculations become more easier. Okay, fine. So I1 is equal to applied voltage by total resistance. Total resistance is 2 divided by 5. 2 divided by 5 is 0.4 ampere. Similarly, I2 is equal to 4 divided by 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 5, 8. So 4, this is 4. 4 divided by 8 is 0.5 ampere. Okay. So once you know that the current is moving in this way, so this is plus sign, this is minus sign. So current is moving in this direction, that means moving from B to 1. So therefore this is plus and minus. Let us, we want the voltage drop across between X and Y. Okay, first we have to say, we have to calculate the voltage drop across X and A, that is VXA plus VAB plus VBY. The sign may be changes according to the orientations. We'll see what exactly then. So we're moving from X to Y. What is the end sign? End sign is 3. The voltage drop is 3 into I1. 3 into I1. End sign is positive here. So therefore say positive. While moving from A to B, what is the end sign? End sign is, this part is 4. So therefore, let me say this is 4. While moving from B to Y, what is the end sign? End sign is minus 2 into I2. Okay, let us substitute the I1 and I2 value here. 3 into I1 is 0.4 plus 4 minus 2 into 0.5. So 3 into 4. 1.2 plus 4 minus it is 1, so its answer is 4.1 plus 1 minus 0.2 is left, 0.2 plus 4 it is 4.2 volts. The voltage drop across X and Y is 4.2 volt. Okay. Thank you guys.